Welcome to the Automating Migration from Windows XP to Windows 8.1 course on the Microsoft Virtual Academy. My name is Kyle Rosenthal and I'll be leading you through this course. It's a 7-module course. If you do have any questions at all as you go through, if you want to send me a tweet through my Twitter account, which is on there, feel free to. Depending on where I am in the world and depending on what time it is, will depend on obviously on how quickly I get back to you. But yeah, please feel free to drop a line. Also, if you find it a useful course as well, let me know that you found it you found it of use. The idea of this course is to kind of take us through the various different challenges that you might find as we move from Windows XP to Windows 8.1. And in particular, obviously, this is something that you need to be on top of pretty much now, mainly because obviously the support for Windows XP is going to be going away in not too distant future. So obviously, yeah, you have to be on top of this. So the idea of this course is to try and give you as much as possible information about the tools that are available and the methods that you might use to be able to make the migration and make the change from XP across to Windows 8.1. If you do want to have a look at some of the other courses that we have, there is also another course which is migrating from Windows XP to Windows 7 as well, depending on where your choice is actually going to be taking you. So the objectives of this particular module, and overall the objectives that we'll have a look at to be able to get us from XP across to 8.1, is to, in general, give you the ability to be able to describe all the components that are required to migrate from XP to 8.1, be able to decide which components and methods might suit your migration, and it is important to make sure that you actually have that sort of knowledge so that you can make an informed decision as to which method is going to be the better way for you to be able to make the change for your environment. And of course, looking at some of the automation that's available. Kyle's motto is that if there's anything you're going to do more than once, then look for a way to be able to automate it. So, like script it or something along those sort of lines. So the agenda for this particular module, we're going to have a look at some of the deployment components and tools, give you a bit of a heads up of the deployment decisions that you might need to make. And this is particularly going to, both of those are particularly really useful for the last deployment you did that was a Windows XP deployment. There's a lot changed in the deployment methodology. There's a lot changed in the deployment tools. We've gone from doing scripted installs in a Windows XP environment to now being able to leverage off an out-of-the-box Windows image file, which we can then use to be able to deploy out. And also things that you need to look at for getting ready for your deployment, and then finally looking at automating the deployment tools. Okay, so what are our main weapons, as they get referred to, the weapons of mass deployment? What are the weapons that we've got available, the components? Okay, so the major components, the Microsoft Deployment Toolkit, the Assessment and Deployment Kit, those two tools are available. They're free downloads from Microsoft, and there's some links at the end of this particular of this module, which will get you to where they exist on the Microsoft website. As well as the Windows deployment services. So we'll have a look at WDS. And obviously, WDS has been around for a while. We're just going to maybe leverage it in a slightly different way than what you would have previously. And also System Center Configuration Manager. Now, System Center Configuration Manager is a whole other topic on its own, and we'll certainly touch on it during this course. But it's more than just deployment, as we'll see. So I'll kind of give you some guidance with regards to when you make the decision point of making the investment to go from a smaller scale in deployment to maybe then using System Center Configuration Manager for deployments. So let's jump in. Okay, so the first one, Microsoft Deployment Toolkit 2013, new version of MDT, and I'll refer to it as the course. I'll sort of flick between Deployment Toolkit to MDT. I'll try generally to be able to just to be MDT because it becomes a mouthful with regards to all of the tools that we're looking at. So MDT, basically what it is, it's a console that holds all of the tools that are available for us to be able to do a deployment. And the main methodology that it uses is it gives us a methodology called a light touch installation, or LTI. Now, with the light touch installation or the light touch installation deployments, what that means is that I can use this to be able to boot up Say, for instance, I can get someone to pixie boot a machine, or I can get someone to run a script, which will then enable a deployment, which has some interaction, and we can cut that down through automation and through effectively creating answer files. With MDT, it's a slightly different sort of process that we can use from within there. But effectively we can cut down how many questions we ask someone, but it can be a choose your own adventure type deployment. So therefore I get I can have someone run a script, and when they run the script, then have that script prompt them for computer name, username, applications that they want to have installed, that sort of thing. It is really a fantastic tool, and it's a fantastic free tool that's available. That then gives us the ability to be able to have a very scalable deployment. Now, the actual deployment itself, this is the beauty of the MDT, is that we can use the deployment to be able to deploy out not only through, say for instance, WDS to be able to perform the deployment, but I can use MDT as the starting point and then finish up at a far more complex environment. So, say for instance, booting off a USB stick, migrating an image across into a configuration manager, as we'll discuss later on in the course. But certainly, it's a great tool to be able to get us started with doing our deployments, and it's also a great tool to be able to get us to actually do a small scale deployment. When I say small scale, my general guidance is around 250 to 500 machines. Obviously, that depends. Like the main thing you're going to look at within here is essentially what the other end is going to be. So if you're starting to get up to 500 machines that you're deploying to, this will scale to that because WDS will scale to that, which is, as I said, a main methodology to actually push the data out. But what'll happen is that on the back end, for the management perspective, that's where System Center Configuration Manager comes in as a bigger sort of bonus for the ongoing management. It can be used for the migration and deployment of basically Windows 7 and above, and Windows Server 2008 R2 and above to be able to do deployments. Anything below that, then you'll need to get an older version of the deployment toolkit. Another tool that's available, again a free tool that's available, the Assessment and Deployment Kit, or ADK. Now with ADK, again, it's a free download. It's available for the Microsoft website, and it just has a whole bunch of tools that are contained in it. It contains things like the Application Compatibility Toolkit. Now the Application Compatibility Toolkit is what gives us the ability to be able to take an application which runs successfully under XP but maybe has some challenges running under Windows 8.1 and create what's known as a wrapper or a shim around it. Now the idea of that is that then maybe does things like, say for instance, when the machine starts up when the application starts up, it'll do a check to see what version of the operating system it's running under. And I like to think of it as being the Jedi mind trick of applications. And essentially what it does is when the application starts up and it says, hey, what's the operating system I'm running in? It'll fool it and it'll go, this is the operating system you're looking for. And the application will nod knowingly and say, yes, this is the operating system I'm looking for, and happily go along its way. Now, obviously, there's more things to it than that. There's a lot more tool, there's a lot more changes that you might need to make in an application compatibility to be able to make it work, but it's a good start, for things like the basic fixes. But yes, the Application Compatibility Toolkit, part of ADK, as well as all the deployment tools. Now, the deployment tools such as DISM, which is our image management, SIM, or Windows System Image Management tool, now that gives us the ability to be able to create unattend files. So again, if you're coming from the XP environment, in XP we used to create an unattend file. We have to go and create unattend.txt files, and effectively it would be a blank screen that you'd start off with and you'd start typing. With the Windows System Image Management tool, it gives us the ability to be able to have a GUI environment. We can load up an image into it and see what the settings currently are in it, and then modify the settings that we want to apply. So it's a great, great, great tool. Windows P, which used to be, the domain of just gold partners, now Windows P is a deployment tool, is available for everyone. So we can actually use that to be able to do deployment of our images, so Windows 8.1 images, and also use that to be able to do some capture as well. So when we're creating an image, we can use Windows P to be able to leverage off that. USMT, the user state migration tool, fantastic handy tool to be able to get to be able to capture settings and application data from a machine before we blow it away. And we'll see that there's different methodologies that we've got from within there as well. And there's also a bit of a challenge, as we'll see in a later module, around making sure that this works under a Windows XP and then a Windows 8.1 environment. So we'll discuss that a little bit later on. The volume activation management tool is contained within there as well. Again, volume activation has changed from the Windows XP days, so you will need to reconsider or at least start considering your activation licenses. The Windows Performance Toolkit, the Windows Assessment Tool, and the Windows Assessment Service. Like a whole bunch of letters, a whole bunch of tools that are available to be able to make sure that everything actually gets up and running, and that you can do a successful deployment. And there is full support within there for LTI deployments as well as the user-driven deployments as well. And you can also use this to be able to plug components of that into Config Manager. In particular, things like, say, for instance, USMT will actually take USMT, create a package out of it, put that into Configuration Manager, and then use that to be able to deploy out so that we can then use the user state migration tools. And you'll see these tools pop up as we go through the rest of the modules. WDS, obviously WDS has been around for a while now in various different versions. With WDS it's an updated version. If you're coming from XP deployments, it's the remote installation services. Okay, it's a lot more than that now, but it's remote installation. It still does that, but it can now do things like, say, for instance, do multicast built in, and has the ability to be able to do a thing called anytime join. Now, the beauty of doing deployments using WDS to do your image deployments is that it can do the multicast deployment in different sessions. So in different speeds. So therefore, you won't necessarily you won't have one particular machine in your environment that will be slowing all the rest of them down. In past, when I've done image deployments, that's been the case. When I've tried to do a multicast, you have one box that has a faulty network card in it, and it just slows everything down. Whereas now what we can do within WDS, it'll actually do a separation of those sessions. So if there's a slower machine, it gets added to the slower session, and everything else can kind of power on through. And the idea of doing any time join is it gives us the ability to be able to have set off a multicast session and then have someone drop out of it and then rejoin later on if need be, or join, if you're doing 100 machines into a multicast session. By the time you get to the 100th machine, could very well be that the first ones were already the deployment's already finished, because the anytime join has kicked off the multicast already, and just sort of it'll catch up once it's in place. We have the ability to deploy both WIM files and VHD files. And the VHD files, the WIM files, again, if you're coming from XP, this is the new Windows image format. This is a built-in imaging tool or built-in image format from within the Windows environment. So you don't have to now go and make additions and changes and that sort of thing and use third-party tools to be able to capture an image. There's native tools that are available to be able to capture and deploy images. VHDs being the virtual hard disks, so we have the ability to be able to do a boot to VHD. And the idea with boot to VHD is to ensure that is to give me the ability to be able to not necessarily install an operating system, but just simply install a portion of an operating system, and then which will be effectively a bootstrap or in Windows PE, which then enables me to then boot into a full-blown operating system. So the beauty of that is that I can then have a very reproducible environment without having to do say, for instance, the operating system that exists on the machine itself currently. I can have this run sort of side-by-side, boot into them separately, but I can have it effectively be a side-by-side sort of environment. And WDS is part of the core delivery method for light touch installations. We'll also discuss that it sort of sits in the back end of doing zero-touch installations using Config Manager as well. You kind of have it, it's a hidden tool that gets used in, and we really only use it for transport, and for the transport sort of process within Config Manager, and again, we'll discuss that later on. And there are two ways that we can manage the WDS, either through the GUI tool, or there is also command line tools available as well. So there's WDS util to be able to import import an image and effectively make an image available and bring in drivers and that sort of thing. So we can actually do that through either, as I said, GUI or through command line. System Center Configuration Manager, prime tool to be able to use for our zero-touch installations. And so we use it to be able to do deployment of operating systems, but it is much more than that. And that's where, Config Manager as a tool to be able to just do deployments is kind of a bit of a waste if that's all you're using it for. It does it really well, but really what we want to do is we want to have a look to see what else we can do with it. And the what else we can do with it is doing application deployment, doing software updates, using it for WSUS management, for antivirus management, remotely administering computers, doing hardware control, hardware and software inventories. That's all the additional parts that Config Manager gives us the ability to be able to do. So that's where, and again, we'll discuss Config Manager more as we go, but that's sort of the extra bits that might push you towards installing Config Manager for managing your deployments. So there's a few things to be able to consider or to consider as part of your deployment decisions. Certainly, the deployment methods that you're going to use. So whether you're going to use zero-touch or light-touch installation. And we'll kind of guide you along the way with regards to the methods that are right for you and then the tools that go along with that. We'll also discuss the deployment scenarios. So the replace a machine, upgrade a machine. So if I'm taking a machine that already exists, and effectively taking that away, then I'm replacing it with another one, or if I'm upgrading the existing box, or alternatively, if it's just a brand new computer that doesn't have anything in play, giving a brand new computer to a new user, that's a new computer sort of scenario. The other tool, or the other thing to consider is to whether we're going to migrate user settings. And in particular in there, there's two decision points to make if we're using USMT, or two things to be aware of. We do need to make sure we're using the right version, and again, we'll discuss that more later on. We'll also need to make sure that we consider the idea of doing a hard link migration, and I'll discuss what that is in a later module. There's another tool which is available called the Windows Easy Transfer Wizard. It's a great sort of one-off process to be able to use. I mentioned it in here because it previously would have been a great thing for you to use to be able to do a migration from Windows XP up, but it's not supported to go from XP across to 8.1. So therefore, it's not an option to be able to do a direct migration. I will discuss another sort of tool that you might be able to use as we go when we get into USMT. So some of the main sort of automation files that we'll use, there is the Windows PE shell ini file, the Windows PE init file, unattend.xml file. So these are just sort of like the custom tools that we can use to be able to either leverage off through MDT, or alternatively, and manage those payloads, or alternatively manage what Windows PE does if we're creating a custom Windows PE environment. Or just simply doing an installation using an unattend file. So these tools here are all things that are really important to be able to make automation happen. Most of them we don't need to directly edit. Most of them will be able to edit through at least the last three will be able to edit or influence it as such through a GUI environment. The first two, though, are certainly give us the ability to be able to make managements straight away. So some automation tips, and these will kind of be repeated as we go through. So use MDT as your base for regardless of how you're going to be doing your deployment. That's my sort of handy hint is use MDT to be able to build your gold images. And we'll discuss MDT some more as we go and some of the reasons for that consideration. And then use either MDT or Configuration Manager to actually do the deployment. And that's going to depend on what your scale is and whether you've got the tools available. And build in some flexibility. So use the MDT database. It's a built-in, we've got the ability to be able to add in additional choices that can be automated when we're using MDT. And again, discuss that in a later module. Build up what I call the grocery list of software images, drivers, and language packs. And the idea of this is that kind of stock the shelves, if you like, of doing your deployment, so that when we go to do a deployment using MDT, we can just simply build up a task sequence that says, okay, bring in this operating system, which is this image, bring in these drivers because it's this particular piece of hardware, and then these are the language packs that we want to be able to do. The more work you do up front, the easier it's going to be able to do the deployment. But make sure that you actually make the choices as to what you're going to deploy. So only deploy what's needed. So we're not chunking up our images. We've actually got an image which is fairly clean and light. Okay, and then above all else, make sure you test. Make sure you test to see what's actually happening, so that you it does work. Before you go to do a full-on scaled out deployment, make sure you test it to start off with. So in summary, we've looked at the deployment components and the tools. We've had a chat about some of the deployment decisions you might make and looked at getting ready to do a deployment. And then in addition, discuss some of the choices about automating your deployment. There's some useful links that I've got put onto the page there. These are available as part of the download for the PowerPoint deck, so make sure you grab a hold of that, and you've got all the links into there to be able to download ADK, the MDT 2013, the System Center, the System Center Home, so you can have a look at that, as well as some really good blog sites, so the Deployment Guys and the Springboard Series the link as well. And we'll discuss sort of all those the tools later on throughout the course. This is part of the MVA course. There are also other options that you'll have for doing your learning. So either through TechNet to be able to download eval copies up to 180 days of all the products that we talk about for Windows Server, Windows 8.1, as well as there are some options for IT camps. Now these are generally no cost camps that are available. You can have a look onto the TechNet site to be able to see if there's one near you. And these are run on a fairly regular basis all around the world. And as I said, we're part of the MVA. So finally, thank you very much. And we'll see you on the next module of the course. And again, if you do have any questions, please feel free to send me through the question through Twitter. And I'll see you on the next one. My name is Kyle Rosenthal.